Oh man, new phone, new camera, and all this stuff to get used to. Anyway, you guys have been following this channel for a little bit and do maintenance for a living as a technician. As you see, got a bunch of parts inventory. I'm sitting back in our shop where we got, this is just the tip of the iceberg of what we got here. But I figured I'd take you through, most of my day of a few work orders here and there, at least what I can film. Sometimes the residents are there and they don't like me filming, and I just try to focus on things. But I'll take you along and give you some highlights of what I do from a day-to-day basis. We got a vacant, somebody moved out, and this faucet's seen better days. We're swapping them out for a better, newer style, but Fitzer. Those are pretty good ones, and we have parts for them. But yeah, just chopping things out of here. I got a bunch of tools. In fact, I even have those rigid multi-plumber's tools and all that, but those things are bulky. They're big plastic and metal things. They're heavy and bulky, and I like something small and compact. These parallel jaw pliers are my new favorite. I still have the, channel locks and other, bite-on things, but for getting nuts and things like that, even this little one at the top here, it's better than the plastic mowing tools sometimes. So, yeah, I like these little things. Nice and useful. Well, I was just checking the work orders, and it looks like we've got a dishwasher down. I actually have two dishwashers to look at today. This will be on our second one. Lower right side of the dishwasher is leaking, and there's actually common with the dishwashers that we've got here. These are Whirlpool appliances and whatnot, and you'll see them dripping from either of those bottom corners there. Otherwise, they're pretty simple. The other one that's common failure is the soap door and spring dealio, complaints of not cleaning or not opening because the residents got this, utensil drawer the wrong way or over in the wrong spot. But if it's leaking, generally what we check here is pop this little cover off, a little air vent dealio, and be all sorts of jock full of stuff in there. This one's actually spotless. So all the steam doesn't build up condensation and doesn't drip because it's getting out of the door. So that's what we're gonna have to check on that work order. I'll bring you along if I can. Wasn't able to take you guys the last one, but next thing is we got a ceiling fan. A resident was saying that their fan was making some noise. I had to take it down. It was making a bearing sort of grinding noise. Okay, I got a new one here. These are the type we go with. They're pretty fast. You just put on four blades, hang it up there, put on the globe, and put on a bulb. So pretty darn fast and easy to put up there. Pretty lightweight too, and they spin up real fast. Not much else to do. These things are still super fast, as I said. Put a bulb in there. Flip the switch back on, make sure it works, and then if it does, put the globe on there. Ah, moment of truth. Get that. Nice and quiet. No more grinding sounds. Get up in high speed. A little bit of shake, but these fans do shake on their high speed. They're just not balanced. They're cheaper fans, but hey, I still like them. There you have it. Globe installed. It operates fan and light at the same switch. The other half of the switch is only half switched outlets in these units. Oh, something going on. Just put a flush valve and a flapper in this toilet. And doing a function check on it. I came in here for another work order and noticed this toilet was dripping by, so I left her a note for a resident here and said, hey, I put in a work order because your fill valve, which clearly we have the old ones that are rusty, and your flapper was leaking by, and save her on the water bill quite a bit. For those wondering what we go with these, fluid flush masters, fluid masters. Easy install, universal. They're real fast, actually. Do these things in 10 minutes tops. And I use the drip tray for ice machines. Those things work great for getting back here at the back wall and under the fill valves for us. So, new supply line. Everything else looks good in there. And water level, just a touch high. Lower that down a touch, and I think we're good to go. Well, there you have it. A bunch of different work orders, a bunch of different things. Show you snippets of what I could and got fixed. But at this point, the only thing I left to do is, hang out for a little bit, clock out, and head on way home.